in the KTU syllabus, it is clearly specified that you have to solve the mesh equations or node equations by using Cramer's rule. Therefore, we have to go to the basics of Cramer's rule. Cramer's rule is used to solve the mesh equation. That is, if you have more than two equations, it is difficult to solve by substitution method. Therefore, we have to use matrix method to solve. By matrix method, we have mainly two methods. First one is Gauss elimination. We know Gauss elimination method. And the second one is Cramer's rule. So let us consider a matrix equation corresponding to a electric circuit consisting of three different meshes. The equation can be represented as resistance matrix, that is R11, R12, R13, R21, R22, R33, R23, R31, R32 and R33 into corresponding current matrix, that is I1, I2, I3 is equal to corresponding voltage matrix, that is V1, V2 and V3. This is a simplified expression, and this matrix we can obtain this resistance voltage matrix, this matrix I is equal to V from by writing the all three mesh equations and rearranging them in the proper form. Therefore, if we get a voltage equation in such a form, we can solve simply for I1 and I2 and I3 by using Cramer's rule. And the representation of I1 is given by, we can determine I1 is equal to 1 by delta R into V1, V2, V3, R12, R13, R22, R23 and R32, R33. This is a representation for I1, and I2 is given by 1 by delta R determinant of R11, R21, R31, V1, V2, V3 and R13, R23 and R33, and similarly I3 is given by I3 is equal to 1 by determinant R into determinant of R11, R21, R31, R12, R22, R32 and V1, V2, V3. These are the three equations for I1, I2 and I3. Let's go through the first equation. Here I1 is given by 1 by delta R. We have to understand what is delta R. Delta R is the determinant of the resistance matrix. Delta R is the determinant of the resistance matrix. This is a resistance matrix and this is a total determinant of the resistance matrix, that is delta R. And I1 is equal to 1 divided by delta R into V1, V2, V3, R12, R13, R23, R23 and R32, R33. That is, for determining I1, we have replaced the first column of the resistance matrix by the voltage equations, voltage column matrix. That is, for determining I1, we have to replace the first column by the voltage, three voltage elements of the voltage matrix. And in order to determine I2, we have to replace the second column of the resistance matrix by V1, V2, V3. And in order to determine I3, we have to replace the third column by V1, V2. And by solving these three equations, by first we have to determine delta R, then we have to determine these three determinant of these three matrices, and by dividing the total delta R divided by the corresponding determinant, we can obtain the values of I1, I2 and I3. Therefore, the procedure is very simple. We have to first determine the determinant of the total resistance matrix delta R, and then for determining I1, we have to firstly replace the first column with the voltage elements. For determining the second matrix, for determining the value of I2, we have to replace the second column by the voltage matrix. And in order to determine I3, we have to replace the third column by the voltage matrix. Therefore, this is a simple rule that we have using for solving the matrix equation. This is the Cramer's rule. Thank you.